Hey guys, welcome back to the shop. Today I'm going to go ahead and start on the leveling pads that I need for the American Pacemaker lathe. What I'm going to be using is some cutouts of old hydraulic rods. So this is 1045 steel, chrome plated, just old scrapped hydraulic rods that I had cut up to make these pads here. I've got two different sizes. So I have some in 5-inch diameter and I have some in 4.5. And since I did not have enough of the 5-inch to do the entire lathe, decided I'm just going to do 4 for the headstock, and then the center support and the tailstock end we'll be using the 4.5. Now I do have 3 extras right here. These are going to be for my friend Lance. He asked if I had any extras that he could get from me for a surface grinder that he needs to level. So while I'm facing all these other ones for me, I'm going to go ahead and face these off for Lance as well. This is the leveling screw off of the American Pacemaker. So this is 1.5 inch, 12 threads there. This the end where it sets down on is turned down to 1 3/8. So we'll probably just use like a, let's just say 1.5 inch end mill. Once we get them all faced, I'll probably just set them up in the mill and have a have an end mill ready. And we can just do a slight little counter bore just to keep this centered. Once you slide these up underneath there, you can adjust this to where it touches and you can kind of get them in the middle there. And it doesn't need to be very deep, maybe about 1/16 or so, you know? So that's what this guy is though. It's got a bore in it, you know, a hole down through there so that you can actually anchor this down to the concrete once you have it level. You know, either have a bolt going through or you have a stud coming up through with a nut, but that's how that is designed right there. All right, we're gonna be using my 6-jaw chucks. I wanted to point this out, I haven't shown these in a while. This is my Edge Technology chuck stop kit right here. It's basically a parallel set. You have 10 different sizes, 10 different lengths of parallel, and 3 of them to a set. And when you get this and you buy one of these guys right here, this kit right here comes with a bunch of these spiders, and these are plastic. I got some right here. And they make them in different sizes, like this is for 3.5. And what these do is fit your through bore on your chuck. And you can machine these if you need to. You can bolt them to a rod and just spin them and turn them to the diameter you need. For me, all I gotta do is just file them a little bit to get them to fit my chuck. But they offer a lot of different sizes to fit most any commonly used chuck. And what I like to do is, instead of swapping out the parallels every time I need one, whenever I need a certain size, I just go ahead and I get another one of these guys right here, because I've got a few of these to go with them. And I go ahead and I just set the parallel up on a new, the center spider there, the spacer. So I wanted either 3/4 or 7/8 for this particular job. I wasn't sure which one I wanted, so I just went ahead and set up both of those. And I keep those set up and I put them in the drawer over there in the cabinet so that if I need it, all I gotta do is grab it and go, okay? And then as I need these others right here, I'll go ahead and mount those to the center support there as well. But these are a nice little tool to have to use as a chuck stop. And I'll show you how they work once we get down there to the lathe. So let's go ahead and get started on it. So first thing you want to make sure you do is just clean the chuck good. Make sure you don't have any dust or chips on it. I've already done that. I've already gone over it and wiped it off. So we should be clear of any kind of machining dust or chips that's on it. All right, and then this is real easy. So you got the center spider there that I said is like cut to fit this board here. I got this one filed pretty close. And the magnets right there, just make sure that you don't have any chips on the magnets. But it's basically gonna be sitting on the parallel, not the magnet itself. So get these in there and just gotta get it in the center like that. And the magnet suck it down to the chuck. It's got a pretty strong bond there to it. So it shouldn't move around anywhere, but you see the plastic spider in the center, that just keeps it from moving. Keeps it right there in the center all the time. All right, just gotta make sure that you have no chips on the face of the parallel. And you take your workpiece and just slide it in there. Just push it in there until it stops. And let the chuck center the part on there. I don't wanna push back hard enough to where it's trying to cock it at an angle. I just want it to stop whatever the natural stop point is right there that it catches on, and let the chuck center it up so that you want both faces to be concentric. In all honesty, this being a leveling pad on the concrete, really is gonna, it's not going to make that much of a difference one way or the other. But we want to make sure that we make them look good and get them faced to a consistent thickness on all 12 of them. Just a little bit closer look of what I just showed you. A little different perspective here. Just like that. There's a chip there or something on it, trash. Just get it centered there like that. Take our work piece. Just hold it up in there against it somewhere. Tighten your chuck up. So what we'll do is face one side of all 12 of them, actually all 15 of them total. And then once we get one side faced, then we'll flip it around and we'll make sure all of them are the same thickness. Once we have the cut established for the other side, we'll go to a zero on the dial indicator every time, and they'll all be the same. They should all be within, you know, 1/2 thousandths each of each other. We got our first one touched off, and I've dialed it in 60 thousandths, or 1/16 of an inch, and that should clean up all these. These weren't the best cut on this. I didn't cut these here. This was cut on a different saw, and the faces aren't very, very true. The other thing I'm pointing out is I'm testing out a different insert than what I've used before. This is a Tungaloy insert. I got a few samples from my local rep to try out. So this is a CNMG 431. It's a PM chip breaker, and the grade is T9225, which is a grade for steel, but they work good for a lot of things like cast iron as well. But we're going to try that. I haven't used this yet, so what I'm looking for is a good manageable chip. So let's see how it does. Running 700 RPM here. So far, so good. It's looking nice. I think I got that on about a 10,000 feed rate. Let's see. Cross feed. Yeah, 10.8. Yeah, I'm liking that. That looks nice. Left a very nice finish on that. It's first cut with that grade insert and that chip breaker. So we'll go ahead and we're going to keep swapping them out and getting one side faced just like this. Nice finish on that guy. If I can get it straight, coming at an angle. Yeah, that one is, there we go. Like I said, those faces aren't very straight. The main thing is you'll make sure that you're chucked nice and concentric on these guys. So we got all the facing finished. So the last stop for the lathe is cutting the chamfer on the corners there. I'm going to do two different depth of chamfers. First side is going to be for the bottom side of the puck, which will be against the floor. Doesn't need a lot, just break the edge. And then the top side, the one you're going to be seeing, I want a larger chamfer there. So what we're going to do is come up like this. I'm going to come up to a zero on my indicator, just like that. Just kind of break the edge there and get rid of the sharpness. And then what we'll do is flip it around. And instead of going just to the zero, I'm going to add 50 thousandths to the dial indicator. Now I want to do it quick to get in to get on and off pretty quick. I can see a little bit of movement there. Some of these may have been a little crooked in the chuck when I first put them in there because some of the saw cuts were pretty bad. So that one's off a little bit. That's okay. So that's the one that goes a little deeper than the bottom side. All right, so we'll set this one off and we'll grab the next one. And what I'm doing is, like some of these, you can kind of still see the saw marks in there where it just barely cleaned them up. So that's the side I'm trying to notice, and it'll be down on the bottom side. Not that it really matters, but you know, when you're making this stuff, you want to try to make things as pretty as you can. That one's running nice and straight there. All right, zero. And on the next one, we'll go to 50 on the indicator. Just like that. Just gonna keep repeating that process right there, okay? This will be the top side right here, and then this will be the bottom side sitting against the floor. Okay guys, we've moved over here to the Kearney and Trekker mill. We've got our larger low profile three jaw chuck mounted down to the table here. This will be a nice tool to use to hold this. All we're doing is we're gonna make a counter bore. I'm gonna use this 1.5 end mill right in the center, approximately 50, 60 thousandths deep. And what we're doing is making a counter bore for this area of the adjusting screw to sit down in and keep it centered. That way, whenever this is slid underneath the machine, we can screw this down to where it catches the center of that. And then this is in the center. It's not, you know, sticking off to one side or the other. It just helps keep it centered is all. That's all we're doing. So I've got my Interrapid test indicator set up here. We just eyeballed the center of that, by the way, with my pointer right there and got it real close. So now we're just gonna use the indicator here to try to get us in a little bit closer. And this is always backwards, this indicator. So I'll probably go the wrong way a few times here. Always the wrong way. All right, that's looking pretty good. Minus one. What I'm doing is I'm using that five as your reference point. So let's take it 1/1000 below that five. And that's what we are there. 1/1000 there and 1/1000 there. So you just pick one number or a line and use it as a reference there. You know, so there we are, moved around to zero. It's moving very little, tenths. So we will zero our table right there, lock it in place, and then we're going to mount up our inch and a half end mill, and I am going to use a collet holder for this guy right there. This is the one we're going to be using. I believe it's a TG style of collet that we're going to use to hold that shank. Get this guy touched off and see how that cutter is going to react. I've got it set to 50 surface feet a minute right now. We can certainly bump that up if we need to. I'm going to go ahead and set a zero right there. Let's see how it does. We're going to use our NogaCool here. I'm not sure if that cutter is going to center cut very well. That's what I'm... I'm going to give it a try and see how it does here. I'm going to try something. Let's power feed. Okay, there's 60 thousandths depth right there. All right, let me drop it back down. Pretty gnarly chip right there. I think that's going to work fine. What I'm going to do is I can't go down much lower with the table here. I'm going to just blow this off and then we'll check it off of the mill here and see how it looks, see how it fits. All right, here's the one that we just cut. I think that's all we need right there. That'll keep it centered, and we're not going to be having 100% contact on this face right there because of the way that the end mill is ground, but I still think it's going to be, I think it's going to work great. So 60 thousandths depth, I'm just going to roll with that. I think that's going to work just fine right there. So we'll go ahead and get all the other ones finished out now. I think I'm going to wrap the table up before we turn it on. Come on. And I'll creep up to it real close with the handle, like that. Then we'll start it. It'll be about 40 thousandths away. 10, 8. Let's see if we touch off in the same place. Okay. Yep. 2,000ths off. I think that's going to be good right there. All right, let's try power feeding this guy up. Let's see if it works or if something shatters and breaks here. Seems to be a nice slow feed rate for our speed. Halfway up. Alright, there we go. Bumped it up one notch on the RPM, so now we're running 139 and one notch on our feed rate here. Just want to see how it's going to handle a little bit faster RPM, just a touch more feed. I can feel it trying to move the table around. It did it. Another one of those cool looking chips there. I've got all 12 of mine done, and now I'm doing the three for Lance here. He went ahead and did some measurement on the leveling screws for his surface grinder, and it's a 3/4 thread. He's gonna take them out and actually turn them down so that there's not threads all the way down at the bottom. So he asked me if I would go 3/4 inches in diameter and 1/4 inch depth, and that's gonna work perfectly fine for him. So we just got the first one done. We'll move on and get these next two done here. This is what the chips look like on this cutter right here. Definitely not wanting to keep them together. It's gonna wad up on us, but we're just gonna go for it and get it done. I am running 0.35 inches a minute on the feed rate here. and we sped it up to 300 RPM. We're through all of our milling over here. You know, I've been using the mist coolant there, so I give everything a nice clean down. Just wipe any of the extra water, you know, the mist off of it everywhere. I'm just gonna spray everything down with this 336. This displaces moisture and it's got rust inhibitors in it as well. It'll keep everything protected and lubricated and shiny. All right, we've got all of our leveling pads now finished up, ready to go. We've even got Lance's three done. I'm gonna be giving these to him shortly. I'm gonna be seeing him in person. So next step is to go down there and start getting the American pacemaker leveled up. I'm gonna have to pull all these leveling screws out. There's a few of them on the machine that are very tight. It's probably got some rust in the threads. So I wanna remove all these from the machine, get them all clean, wire brush the threads, and make sure they screw in and out of the tapped holes nicely, and then we will work on getting the lathe leveled up. So this has been a fun little project so far, and I am ready to see the machine nice and leveled like it should be. So next phase from here, we'll meet you down at the new shop at the American Pacemaker.